I'm Jessica Fries-Gaither, and I'm the lower school science teacher here at Columbus School for Girls. I wanted to take a moment to introduce you to the approach that I will be using in lower school science, as it's most likely different from the science that you experienced when you were in elementary school. So the type of program that I'm implementing is called inquiry-based science. And at the heart of inquiry is asking and answering questions about the natural world. So we'll always begin our investigations with a question that is testable by science. Not all questions are testable, and I stress to the girls that even if they're not testable, they're still good questions. They're just not ones that we can answer through a scientific lens. Questions may be posed by the girls themselves, or they might be questions that I provide to them to help shape an investigation. But either way, we're asking a question and then looking for an answer through what I call a minds-on experience. This might be a hands-on experience that uses materials and laboratory equipment, or it might be a question that we seek the answer through research, books, and websites, or data sets that have been collected by someone else. The second approach is helpful when we are dealing with something that is impossible for us to study directly, such as the solar system, or something that is very small, such as a cell. But students are using evidence to then come up with their own conclusions, or what I call claims, evidence-based claims. I've introduced this vocabulary to your girls, and it's become part of our daily conversation, so don't be surprised if it shows up at home and they ask, "What's your evidence?" when you talk about something in the natural world. Finally, after we've drawn our evidence-based claims, we then turn back to textbooks and to websites and to children's literature to compare what we have found to what experts in the scientific community know to be true. This is very different from the approach that you probably experienced in school, which was lecture heavy and full of notes and the teacher providing the right answers. We really want to have the girls immersed in authentic experiences in which they make sense of their own world and then compare and learn from what the scientists over many hundreds of years have discovered. So that's inquiry science in a nutshell. Thanks for joining me, and I hope you'll join me next time as we talk about science notebooks and their role in our classroom.